Hello, today I'm going to show you how to use Spartan Search, which is this search box you see on the library's homepage. It searches across all of our databases and materials. I always like to use the Advanced Search, which you can access once you've clicked into it. The Advanced Search allows us to separate out the concepts we're looking for so that the database understands more clearly what we need. For example, let's say we're doing a search where we want to know how nurses can help dementia patients. We could search something like this, nursing interventions and dementia. You can also add a new line to add more concepts, and this and line can be changed to or not. For example, we might want to say dementia or Alzheimer's so that we are covering more ground in terms of the words that might be used. Over here, you can also choose to limit by the years. So let's do the last 10 years and say since 2012. Once we hit search, we get more options on the left side to filter. The most commonly used one would probably be peer reviewed. Once you apply the filter, you get the option to lock it in place so that it stays there even if you continue searching. Now we can browse through our tools here, our results, and see what we like. When you click into an article in Spartan Search, you will be able to scroll down to see the subject headings, which are useful for you to borrow as you continue your search. These are great terms because you're speaking in the language of the database. You'll also see the abstract. In Spartan Search, it's called the description. This gives you a quick overview of what the article is about and helps you understand whether it's a good fit for you without having to read the entire article. If you like an article, you can email it to yourself, save the permalink, or save the citation. I always recommend students don't save the web address from the top because that is session specific and won't necessarily take you back to this article. The permalink is what you want. If you want to access the article, you're going to go under View Online and click through one of these links. And ta-da! On the left, you'll see full text PDF, but you can also scroll down to see the full text. There are a few different databases, so sometimes it'll look slightly different, but they all have similar functionality, including email, citation, download a PDF, and a permalink. I hope this helps you the next time you do a search.